हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ मोहित गर्गे एंड दिस इज डिजिटेमी, डी डिजिटल अकेडमी, एंड दिस वीडियो इज़ ब्रॉट टू यू बाय मिशन यूपीएससी। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रेजेंटेशन विल सी द वीवीआईपी चॉपर स्कैम दैट इज ट्रेंडिंग इन द न्यूज़, इन द सोशल मीडिया, इन द मीडिया। विल सी द फैक्ट्स एंड हाउ इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, दैट ऑल विल सी विच आर द वेरियस एजेंसीज इन्वॉल्व, how the procurement is done, all these things will come to know. But before starting, in case you want to suggest me anything, these are my contact details. You can write to me in on this contact detail. Also, you can join Mission UPSC Instagram page, where you will be able to interact with a number of civil service aspirants in order to exchange the knowledge with them. Also, please subscribe to this channel. In if you want to see more these kind of videos, please subscribe to my channel. Also, one announcement for undergraduate students: we are having internship programs. In case you want to teach India through online tutorials, please join our team, Digidemy. You can contact me on these particular details. So let's get started. So what exactly is VVIP chopper deal? Let's see. The presentation will be only based on the facts. Will not be alleging anybody in this particular presentation. So first is contract. The contract was signed in 2010 with Augusta Westland Company. Then how the controversy emerged? It emerged after the arrest of Giuseppe Orsi, who is the CEO of Finmeccanica, which is the parent company of Augusta Westland. And why the controversy emerged? It emerged because he was arrested for the reason of bribing Indian politicians in this particular contract. Hence the controversy emerged. Then various allegations took place. The UPA government was alleged by opposition of having taken bribe in this particular issue. Hence, Defense Minister A.K. Antony ordered an investigation by CBI. Obviously, opposition started imposing pressure on UPA government. Then UPA government introduced a motion in Rajya Sabha for an investigation led by 30-member Joint Parliamentary Committee. But the parties thought that there are various legal aspects such as extradition of accused foreigners, then custodial interrogation. JPC can have none of these powers and leaving it ineffective. And they walked out of Rajya Sabha in order to oppose the investigation by Joint Parliamentary Committee. And they were demanding investigation to be done by Supreme Court of India. In 2014, UPA government cancelled the deal on the pact of integrity. So what was the integrity pact? We'll see it afterwards. But just now remember, this is just the outline of the events. So the deal was cancelled on the grounds of integrity pact. And after it, the recovery of advance was done by the UPA government. So this is the outline. Now let's see in detail what exactly happened and just try to understand which are the agencies involved in this particular investigation, then in government how the procurement is done, how the proposals are floated. So try to understand all these things. So let's see the history of it. In 1985, India bought 21 Westland helicopters after Margaret Thatcher, then British Prime Minister, persuaded her Indian counterpart Rajiv Gandhi to ignore the advice of experts who were against the sale of Westland 21 helicopters. The money for the deal, around 65 million euros, came out of Britain's budget and it was given to India specifically for purchasing the helicopters. Westland at that time was solely British aerospace company that manufactured helicopters after World War II. However, the copters that were sold proved to be a disaster. Two of them crashed in 1988, killing around 11 people. Then in 1991, the helicopters were withdrawn from the service on safety grounds. Then the entire fleet of Westland helicopters was packaged off to Britain for the scrap value of just rupees 900,000 euros. During the period of operation of those helicopters, Pawan Hans incurred an aggregate loss of 95 crores, while British National Audit Office concluded that its government lost more than 105 million euros due to the deal. So now let's see the chronology of events, how the procurement is done in various departments of government. In 1999, there was NDA government. Indian Air Force highlighted the need of modern replacement of Mi-8 VIP helicopters. Earlier, India used Mi-8 VIP helicopters, which is a Russian company. They had few requirements. One of the key requirements of the RFP was the helicopters should be able to fly at around 6,000 meters, that is 19,000 feet, with full load. To fly for altitude like Siachen and Tiger Hill, so that was the reason behind it. Requirement. After trials, only one helicopter, that is Eurocopter's helicopter, was able to fly at that altitude. The Agusta Westland A101 failed to make list after flight evaluation as it could not fly above 18,000. So that according to these requirements put by Indian Air Force, Eurocopter's helicopter was eligible for procurement and Agusta Westland helicopter. Then in 2003, Indian Air Force sent its evaluation report to Prime Minister Office. Who floated the inquiry? Indian Air Force. And it sent the report to Prime Minister Office. The Brajesh Mishra, who was the National Security Advisor and Principal Secretary to Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he asked the Special Protection Group that guards India's VIP for its comments. So PMO took the comments of Special Protection Group. But Special Protection Group commented that the cabin height of a Eurocopter is 1.39 meters and it is very low. Neither the VIP nor the SPG would be able to stand upright inside such a cabin. That Brajesh Mishra wrote to the Air Chief Marshal S. Krishna Swami, who had taken over from ACM Tipnis in 2001. He expressed concern on two points: whether the helicopters must be able to fly on at this particular height. Also, we have arrived a single vendor situation because of the specifications that it must be able to fly at 19,000 feet. Also, the cabin height should be 1.8 meters. So hence, in 2003, Indian Air Force, in consultation with Special Protection Group, they drew up new requirements, and the specifications said helicopters must be able to fly at 4500 meters and cabin height should be 1.8 meters. So these are the new requirements. Meanwhile, in 2004, Air Marshal S.P. Tyagi took over as Indian Air Force Chief. It took Air Headquarters and the Defense Ministry Acquisition Wing another 3 years to issue fresh request for proposal. That was 2006. And in 2006, the government changed to UPA government. So the new request for proposal was floated, which went by specifications finalized in 2003 by Indian Air Force and Special Protection Group. And it was issued to 6 different vendors. And it was the time when Pranab Mukherjee, who is the current president of India, he was the defense minister. The 3 companies responded to the request for proposal. First was the makers of Mi helicopters that India were using earlier. Then second was Sikorsky. It is United States company. Then third is Agusta Westland company, which we are talking about. Meanwhile, in the Defense Ministry put in place a new concept. In 2007, the defense procurement procedure. Under this, all the companies that bid for contracts above 1 million have to sign an integrity pact. That binds company to give an undertaking that no bribes would be paid or that no agent should be used in the contract. The Russian company manufacturers of Mi-72, they withdrew from the deal at the early stage, refusing to sign this integrity contract. Then left Sikorsky and Agusta Westland. And this time, Fali H. Major, who himself is a helicopter pilot, he had taken over as Indian Air Force Chief. Now in 2008-2009, the evaluations and trials of S-92 and AW-101, that is Agusta Westland A-101, began and continued over the next couple of years. According to Indian Air Force, the S-92 was found to be non-compliant on 4 counts. That is, S-92 is Sikorsky company's helicopter. It was found non-compliant on 4 the particular things. So, 15,000, it could not fly above 15,000 feet without maximum power. Then, its hover out of ground effect was insufficient. Then, its drift down altitude did not meet the requirement. And its missile airborne warning system was not up to the mark. So these are the 4 things that was identified. And whereas Agusta Westland had 3 engines, so it was a bonus. According to Indian Air Force test pilots, since one engine failure still meant it had 2 engines to fall back upon. So that was the bonus thing. Now, in 2009, Air High Quarter sent its recommendation to Defense Ministry, and various technical specifications and financial requirements, all those were things were checked by Defense Ministry, and after it contract was signed in February 2010, and it was given to Agusta Westland. By that time, Air Chief Marshal P.V. Naik was the Air Chief. Now, after the contract was signed in 2012, Agusta Westland helicopters arrived in India. There were 3 helicopters arrived in India in late 2012. In 2013, the controversy emerged after the arrest of Jeev Orsi, but he was arrested for bribing Indian politicians in chopper issue. So that gave rise to the controversy. Then UPA government cancelled the deal. Then they recovered the advance. Also, they instituted a probe against the alleged middlemen and beneficiaries. And in 2013, Central Bureau of Investigation came in the picture. They said Indian Air Force had been opposing vehemently any suggestion on lowering altitude requirements before SP Tyagi became the Air Chief. After Tyagi took over, the Air Force conceded to reduce the height requirement, allowing Agusta Westland to re-enter the bidding process. This was said by CBI. In March 2013, CBI said it had found evidence against former Indian Air Chief SP Tyagi that suggested that he had extended favors to UK-based Agusta Westland by changing specification requirements for VVIP choppers. The agency registered first information report, that is FIR, against Tyagi and 12 others. The people who were included in FIR were CEO Satish Bargodia, who is the brother of former Union Minister Santosh Bargodia, and Managing Director Pratap Agarwal. Then, after days later, CBI issued lookout notice for Tyagi and his 3 cousins and 5 others. In 2016, the government changed to NDA. And in 2016, what we are currently seeing, the buzz, the trending issue is chopper deal. So why it is trending? So in April 2016, Jeev Orsi, the former chief of Finmeccanica, who owns Agusta Westland, along with Bruno Spangolin, who is the chief of Agusta Westland chopper division, they were sentenced to 4.5 years imprisonment by the Milan court. The Milan court is equivalent to Indian High Court. So the court also ordered two executives to pay 7.5 million euros, and the two officials were held guilty of paying bribes to Indian officials. So the final decision was given by Milan court, and they were sentenced to imprisonment. That's why the issue came in 2016, and currently there is buzz in Rajya Sabha and in media, social media. So in July 2014, Arun Jaitley, as defense minister, issued an order which put hold on all the procurement and acquisition cases in pipeline with all the six companies involved in the scam, including Agusta Westland and Finmeccanica. So CBI probe into this matter is ongoing in India. Then London-based consultant Christian Mitchell, who is one of the middlemen, is currently on the run. There is an Interpol red corner notice against him and him following India's move to arrest him in this case. The Milan court had heard notice that Mitchell was paid over 44 million euros by Agusta Westland for various contracts. So since he was the middleman, the integrity pact was breached. This could be the issue in which could be presented in the court or presented as a violation of integrity pact. Also, the enforcement directorate, they had been pursuing this case also. With Michelle's business dealings in India being probed, the enforcement directorate in 2015 attached assets worth rupees 7 crore alleged to be in the name of cousin of former Indian Air Force chief. And finally, Italian court finds the middleman who had agreed for 7.5% commission. Italian courts find that the middleman had agreed for a 7.5% commission to Indian Air Force officers and politicians in the deal. The Central Bureau of Investigation's first information report says that Guido HK and Carlos Querosa managed to send 5.6 million euros through Mohali-based IDS Infotech and Chandigarh-based Aeromatrix Info Solution Private Limited to India and kept the remaining amount of 24.3 million euros received from Agusta Westland with themselves in the account of IDS Tunisia. The HK had earlier claimed that 6 million euros were paid to Indian Air Force and 8.4 million to bureaucrats, with politicians also getting a cut in Agusta Westland's deal. The Milan Court of Appeals in Italy, in its judgment, took a note of conversation between the three middlemen, Carlos Guerosa, Christian Mitchell, Guido HK, who mentions Mrs. Gandhi as being the driving force behind the VIP, and her close aides Ahmed Patel and Pranab Mukherjee. In the letter dated 15th March 2008, Christian Mitchell wrote to Peter Hewlett saying, "Dear Peter, since Mrs. Gandhi is the driving force behind the VIP, she will no longer fly with MI8. Mrs. Gandhi and her closest advisor are the aim of the High Commissioner, Senior Advisor Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, obviously the main figure. Then there is Ahmed Patel's secretary." One particular note from middleman reportedly described Gandhi as the driving force behind the deal. This is the whole matter, or you can say this is the outline of the matter. These are the various facts put in front of you. So that's it. In case you have any suggestions for me, you can always contact me, and let's see, the decision will be given by the Supreme Court. We are nobody to decide. So thank you very much for watching and stay tuned. Please subscribe to this channel, follow this Mission UPSC page on Instagram. You will be able to interact with many civil services aspirants over there. So thank you very much.